And it's not like I'm surprised by it.
No.
We're now joined by former Baylor wide receiver, Washington receiver as well, but also sidelined for Baylor Radio. Ricky Thompson's been on with us quite a bit this year, last week, the off week. Ricky, thank you. What was Texas week like when you were there?
You know, Smokey, I'd be lying if I said it wasn't different, because it was. I think it was a game that we really anticipated very highly. 90 miles away, University of Texas, that was enough. I think we were really highly motivated, and I think Grant, Coach Taft, did a good job of making sure that we were. I think we went into it with a really motivated feeling that we wanted to show the big guys we could play. And I'm guessing our guys this week are thinking the same.
Yeah, I wouldn't think, even with a generation of kids that's grown up where Texas has been, you know, average at best, that it's lost very much of its luster at all, because it's still Texas.
Exactly. And I think the name alone means something. And I just think it's an added motivator for our guys. And I'm going to be really surprised if we don't play pretty well. I mean, let's face it. Texas has always had talent. They're always going to have talent. They're going to have some of the best talent. That doesn't always make you a good football team.
So, Ricky, Baylor off the off week at 6-1. Had the nice win over BYU before heading into the off week. Just your thoughts on what you'd like to have seen the team work on, or, you know, sharpen up, what have you. What as far as you're concerned, was most needed from this past week?
Well, first of all, let's go back to the open date. Texas also had one.
Mm-hmm.
There are always good times for an open date. Probably not ever a bad one, unless you just lost a game. And then as a player, you really hate those 2 weeks. Because coaches will take advantage of it. But I wish we would have played them last Saturday. I mean, from my point of view, I think we were playing really well. I don't think they were. They were reeling a little bit, and I wish we would have gone ahead and played. But we didn't. We had the week off. I just think, before last week, I would have told you, let's work on the penalties. God, how many games have you played where you had zero? I don't remember one.
Mm.
So you can't work on that. I just think that still, I think pass coverage, secondary-wise, you've got to think about that. How many big plays did we give up against Brigham Young? Now, on a lot of those drives, they didn't go in and score. They didn't put six on the board, and we made the play after the catch. But I think we've got to work some with that secondary, not give up the big passing plays. You take those away, BYU did nothing offensively. They just, Algiers, what, 36 yards, 33 yards, had 191 last week against Washington State. So I think if there's anything that I pick, I just say you've got to do something in that secondary to stop the big plays.
Yeah, because they have some dynamic Xavier Worthy and Casey Thompson. It seemed like he took a step back. He's also had an injury with his hand. What someone, Mike, in fact, on the text line brought up how Baylor shut down Brigham Young and Algiers, but Bijan Robinson's a different animal, right?
Yeah, as good as I've seen. He's kind of the Breece Hall type guy that he's got. Not just, I'm not sure how fast Algiers really was. I know he was shifty, great running back, but Bijan can fly. And if he gets loose, he's gone. So I think that's the big difference. And I think you've got to really tackle well. You've got to get him with the seven guys up front. Do not let him get in the secondary, because he's scary. And I think that's the difference between a running back like that and some of the others that you see, is he is a real home run threat. You just can't give him that space.
Ricky, do you look at what Texas has gone through the last couple of weeks and see a common thread? Is it they're not the condition they need to be yet, that they fade in the fourth quarter? Is it that Steve Sarkisian, you know, still obviously needs a little more time to put his system in? What do you see has been gone on with them since really the first quarter of that Oklahoma game?
You know what? I just think it's the seed of doubt. I just really think they're not comfortable. They're not comfortable when they have the lead. They don't have that killer instinct to put these teams away. Not going to say they won't have it this Saturday, but I think that's something that's been lacking. And I think if you don't have it, it makes a huge difference. And then you particularly against Oklahoma State. You're driving down to go up by, what, three scores? Mm-hmm. And at least at that point in the ballgame, you think, well, we're on the right side of this. But then you get a 85-yard, whatever it's interception return for a touchdown, all of a sudden it's 17-13. Completely changes the game around. And I think once they hit that, they were reeling and had those doubts that they weren't really playing their game. They were just playing not to lose after that. And that just doesn't work. And I just think they really have that doubt and maybe not the killer instinct to put it away. And I think that grows on you. It does. Again, we go back. I certainly don't think it's talent because they have the players.
Ricky, what do you think about Baylor's chances to run the football effectively this weekend? Obviously, that's where the offense kind of starts and stops. When they're not able to do that, it puts them in a, you know, one-dimensional just like any other offense, but particularly with this wide zone. What do you see from the Texas defense, and where do you think the Baylor offense can find success?
I think they can match up pretty well with them. I think Texas has had some injuries up front. They had a couple of walk-ons that they've even played part of the time this year. I think that we can run the football on them. And Craig, I agree. If we don't, it's a problem. I think it's going to be a long day. I think we have to run the ball because our passing game is built off the play action. I do think if Gary can hit a couple of play action throws early, that will help with the passing game. And I know even against BYU, one of the passes to Taquan I thought was really exceptional off the play action that helped the run game later. And then R.J. Sneed had the great catch on the comeback route, the waggle play action to the home side, if you all remember that. Mm-hmm. Sneed came back, caught the ball, and then made a good run after the catch. But I think we can run the ball on them. I think we match up pretty well. And I think over the term of a game, if we don't run for 150, 175 yards at least, I think we have a real problem in this ball game Saturday.
You know, we were talking about the running game and what Abram Smith and the story of how he got to Baylor with Montgomery knew about him. In fact, he committed to Tulsa, ended up at Baylor. Lebby knew about him. Joey McGuire had played against him when he was at Cedar Hill. Isn't it crazy sometimes how these stories weave through things and how people get to where they got? What was your recruiting story?
Well, I was just thinking about that, really. I'd actually committed to Texas, and Cotton Davidson had taken over the receiver's job here. Coach Hart, obviously on the track side, had recruited me some, and you know, those stories do weave. When Cotton came here, it kind of flipped me from going to a team that was running the wishbone and throwing about five times a game to a team that was supposedly going to air it out. And that day, that meant maybe throw it 20. You know, that was the extent of the passing game. But it is funny. And Abram Smith, gosh, what a coup it is for Baylor to pick him up. And probably didn't realize it at the time. But, guys, this guy's good. I mean, he is a tough downhill runner. But even more than that, I think his eyes are incredible. I've gone to the end zone a couple of times just to watch from that angle, and this kid is really good at making one cut and then going. But that one cut sounds really simple. It's not. You've got to have the eyes to see that when you're running full speed, and I think he is one of the best I've ever seen at it. And that's, you can teach and try to tell these guys something, but I'm not sure you can really teach that. I think that's something that's instinct, and he has it, and he is a really good running back that I think anybody would take.
Ricky Thompson, sideline reporter for Baylor. Baylor Radio with us on Sikkim 365 Radio as well. Now, Ricky, obviously 6-1, bowl eligible. I know that was a me, and this is me. I'm one of those walk before you run guys, and it kind of reminds me of the second year under Coach Rule, or when Art tried to get a team into the postseason, they finally did with a win against Kansas State in 2010. Are they ahead of schedule of what you thought this year?
Yes, they really are. I'll back up. I thought they had a chance to win six this year and get to a bowl. I didn't think it would be after seven games. I'll be honest with you. I didn't think they would be there. They're a lot better than I thought they would be. And, Smokey, I agree with you. The coaches won't say that. They won't say that's a big hurdle. They won't say that's a big milestone. but it is. These kids want to go to bowl games. Recruits want to see you go to bowl games. And I think it's a huge milestone to get that sixth win. I really do. To get it this early in the season, I think they'll build off that. I don't think six is where we finish. I think we finish with several more wins than that. We'll see as we go down the road. You know, we've got a tough schedule here coming up, Texas, TCU, then Oklahoma here. Mm-hmm. That's a tough stretch. But you pull out two of these three and you end up 8-2, whatever it may be, you may have a chance at that championship game. So we'll see where that goes.
Ricky, thank you, man. What are your thoughts about Texas Tech making a coaching change? 5-3. I know it was a bad loss. As a player, you didn't have to experience that. But what is it like, you think, for a program when that happens?
Well, I was shocked, to tell you the truth. I thought that might happen after the season if they hit a streak here toward the end and lost several games. I knew that Wells was on the hot seat, so to speak. But at this point, after a 25-24 loss to Kansas State, I was surprised. And luckily, they've got a guy up there in Cumbie that's a Tech guy that will try to lead them the rest of the year. But that is a tough to impossible situation when you've got an interim guy. And I really do feel for those guys going through it. And I don't know, Smoke, I was surprised they did it at this point.
Thank you very much, Ricky Thompson, Baylor radio sideline reporter, former Baylor and Washington receiver, Sikkim 365 Radio. We appreciate his time. The 5 o'clock